What's going on, ladies and gentlemen of YouTube? Shogu here with another virtual reality video. And today I'm bringing you the Hell Dimension VR update that was released on October 7th of 2017. I do apologize for it being October 21st. I had some family coming in and out of the house that I had to help house. And now that they're gone, I can focus on my Vive and YouTube videos a little bit more. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the update. The update reads as follows on Steam. Hi players, we have been working hard to make this game fun based on the community feedback, and here are what we have updated. Ranged insect monster reduced its attack range. I can attest to this. I call them the poison insects. They have been coming a little closer, and I've noticed in my gameplay that hitting them with the revolver has gotten a little easier. So, and I don't know if range has anything to do with the amount of damage that is dealt, because it seems like with a normal pistol, I kill them in 1 to 2 bullets faster. Before it was 7 or 8 bullets, and now it feels more like 5 or 6. Cannot confirm though, haven't played it enough to confirm that, but more gameplay will reveal what happens. Alien monster stop further from player than before. This is something else that I can attest to. The little speedlings, I don't know exactly what they're called, but I call them speedlings, reference to StarCraft. They, you know, the little guys that run up to you super quick. You know, they usually come in packs. They would normally come up to you super close, and you have to reach for the sky and then aim down in order to hit them. I don't really necessarily have to do that now. I kind of have to aim up a little bit to get them, but, or just put the gun in my face and then point down a little, but it's not to the mass degree that it was before. Unless they come directly at me and then sit right where I'm at and then try and attack Michelle. Then I kind of have to take a step back, reach for the sky like Woody, and aim down and put one in his head. But overall, they definitely do sit back a little farther from you than they did before the update. Next thing is, points get from block account set the maximum of 1,000. I'm going to be quite honest with you. I have no idea what that means. At all. The only thing that I've seen change with the point system is on challenge mode, it seems a little more difficult to get points up as quickly as before the update. Points get from block account set the maximum of 1,000. The only thing that I can see is maybe before the update we were getting more than 1,000 for the big gargantuan monster. I forget his name. It escapes me now, but it's not Destroyer. I don't think it's Destroyer. The big guy with two massive, you know, balls for fists that would do the slow walk. If you played the last level, Cliff, during the last wave, wave 10, they have 4 of them coming right at you at once. I'm assuming that you used to get more than 1,000 per kill on that, but I don't think so. This one just escapes me. But I know that the points you get per round is not capped out at 1,000. I've gotten 1,100 and 1,200 before, so unless that's a glitch and that is what it's supposed to be, I'm pretty certain that you're not capped out at 1,000 points after each wave. Anyway, maybe the devs can comment on this video, or someone who knows what they're talking about comment on this video and enlighten me and the rest of us onto that. Would be much appreciated. Anyway, moving on. Added upgradable attack power feature to Michelle. Now this is something I've been begging for, and I have been looking forward to, and I have rather enjoyed. You can now you can't upgrade her weapons or anything per se. She still only wields the pistol, but it is a more powerful pistol. It actually does the damage of your pistol after a while. I think it's at level 4, I want to say. About level 4 is where it starts to do the same amount of damage as you would with you wielding a pistol. Only problem still is the fact that after every monster that dies, she automatically reloads. Just like that. It could be 2 speedlings that come up on her. She goes pop, pop, it's dead. Reload. Pop, pop, reload. And 5 of them come up. and you could kill the one that she's killing. She can only put one bullet in. Pop. Reload. Move on to the next one. You kill it before she even has a chance. Reload. That is kind of annoying. I think that the game should understand how many bullets she has in that gun and go off that amount of bullets and empty the clip. Empty the damn clip. And then have her reload. Not pop a couple bullets. I mean, come on. I mean, I know we've all played Call of Duty or Battlefield or whatever your, you know, preference be. Mine is Battlefield out of those two. And I know we all put a couple bullets out, reload. Yes, even the big LMGs that have 200, you know, bullet magazines. Nope, I might need those two last bullets. But this needs to be addressed. I'm glad that she can do more damage now, but the reloading thing needs to be addressed and dumbed down a little. You know what I mean? Moving on to the next part. Added current player on multiplayer tab. This is something that I cannot attest for because I have yet to play online. I've tried a few times and I have never been able to actually get a match going. No one's ever online. So, and I don't have the patience to wait for someone that may or may not even be there. So that one we'll see once the player base gets a little bigger. Removed tutorial requirement on challenge mode. This isn't something I ever really ran across. I did survival mode first and then went to challenge mode because I understood what challenge mode meant as soon as I read it. So I backed down. I did survival mode. I'm assuming that you had to do survival mode before challenge mode in order to do the tutorial and in order to play challenge mode. Otherwise, the game wouldn't let you. I don't know, but I already did survival mode. I want to do the normal game before the unlimited waves. That's just how I am. And last, and in this entire thing, probably the least, changed order of main menu. I don't get the point. I don't know why they spent time thinking about this. It was just fine the way it is. Survival mode up top. The basically normal, quote unquote, mode of the game. Up top, front and center. Very first thing that you do. There's no problem with that. Now, challenge mode's front and center. So I guess that's what it's supposed to be. Arcade mode, quote unquote, first, and then story, quote unquote, second. I mean, hey, you know, doesn't really matter in the grand scheme of things, but don't understand why this is even a thing, really. And then they also had two bugs that they fixed. Both of them I never actually came across, though. So thankfully, I don't have to rant about that. They fixed not enough point text blocks on the weapon selection. So I'm assuming that they would try and get, say, the shotgun when they had enough points, and it would tell them that they didn't, which would piss me off, not gonna lie. And they fixed the wrong, incorrect health silhouette on challenge mode. I'm just gonna ignore the double negative, wrong, incorrect. So we're just gonna say they fixed the incorrect health silhouette on challenge mode. I don't, this sounds like it might actually affect the gameplay, not really sure, but I mean, if it's just both of these seem like they are definitely game breaking almost. The first one definitely, second one seems a little, the silhouette on challenge mode seems like it's more cosmetic than anything, but I digress. And that is it for this update. Hopefully they will keep at it with this game. It's a very fun game. Like I said, I love playing it and I will be playing it for some time to come. Until Fallout 4 and Skyrim make the jump to VR. I am excited about that to no end. Until then, I will be playing this and probably a few others, but mainly this, because I like spooky, and this is spooky month. I love this shit. Anyway, and last note, again, I do apologize for the span in videos. My main problem this time, I have a long list of excuses, I know, but this time it was legitimate. I was trying to make a challenge mode video for you guys, and I was trying to make it work with my Blue Yeti. I tried all these different ways. The sound, I did not like the sound that it was producing. It sounded like I was in a cave. Go to my survival mode video. You'll know exactly what I'm talking about. And after buying different stuff, to hook up to my Vive to make a mic work, an actual headset mic. I finally got it working. I finally have some decent audio that I can use to go in room scale, so I can finally get that challenge mode video I've been trying to get out for probably the better part of 3 weeks now. Just about when October, it was the beginning of October when I was trying it. And I couldn't do it. I didn't want to put out a video where I sounded like I was in a cave. So, the next video will be challenge mode on Hell Dimension. I am looking forward to it. I hope you are too. And if you like, that's about it for this video. If you like what you saw, if you like what you heard, please be sure to rate, comment, and subscribe. Keep your nose clean. And as always, have a good one. Peace out.